Hello and welcome to another video. In today's episode, we are going to be taking a look at IP addresses and MAC addresses and what's the difference between them, what's the point of these. And the reason for me making this video is because recently I watched this Mental Outlaw video on MAC addresses explained, and it explains a lot of the basics of MAC addresses, and I highly suggest you to check out Mental Outlaw's video. I think he's on YouTube and also Odyssey, but I have no idea what the channel name on Odyssey is. But anyways, I found his explanation a little too short. Well, it's an 8-minute video, so it's it doesn't go into the kind of details that I want to talk about today. So let's get into it. If we take a look at how the internet works, well, it is kind of complicated, because basically what we want is an application on one computer to be able to talk to another application running on another computer. So we need some kind of process-to-process communication. But of course, the programs are running on the computer, so we want some way to transfer these messages between the hosts. And of course, there are a lot of different programs that want to talk to each other. There are a lot of different computers or mobile devices that want to talk to each other. And if we just tried to implement all types of, like, for every application, like if you want to write, I don't know, maybe like a file synchronization program that synchronizes files between two computers, and you had to write like every minutia of how to put the data from one computer to another, that would be very difficult. So what is done instead, of course, is we can just divide the steps that we need to take to get the data from one application to another into multiple steps. So this is, there's the transport layer, which will be all the software that will make sure that one computer can send data to another computer, and there is the internet between these computers, so those computers don't even have to be on the same network. So the internet itself is internet, if you didn't know. So like international is between multiple nations, internet is between multiple networks. So as you can see on this very nice drawing that you can see I got from Wikipedia, that there can be multiple computers connected through multiple networks, but the internet is going to make sure that you can reach through all these different networks and get your data from one place to another. And this other drawing here shows you how your data gets incorporated by the application data gets some header from the transport layer that will tell the other computer what is the application this data is coming from and what is the application this data is coming to. And similarly, the internet layer will add the information to all of this. So on the networks, we will know what computer we are looking for through this kind of the IP header, and then of course the link layer, which will transport the data between the computers, will also add its own additional metadata over there that will help us getting from one place to another. And so for the IP address is coming from the internet protocol address. So we have a protocol through the internet, and currently the most popular way is the IPv4, which has these kind of IP addresses that are coming in four sections, while the MAC address is this is the medium access control. This is a different layer of this communication, and we have these addresses, which has these six segments. And in Mental Outlaw's video, he talks in a great detail how these numbers are made up and whether you can change it or what does it mean. So the main differences between the IP address and MAC address is, why do we need both? Why can't we just use one type of address? Well, the IP address we need is because this address will be used. It's supposed to be kind of a unique, globally unique identifier that will lets you identify the exact computer you want to send the data to. But of course, some of the servers have a unique IP address. So in case of like a, I don't know, if you have a web server, it is nice that this web server has a unique IP address, and wherever you are from the world, you can just address this computer and this computer will deliver you the website you are looking for. But of course, it's not true for most of the computers. So if you are at home and your computer is behind a router, or it's you use a VPN or use proxies, then of course you might not have a unique, a globally unique IP address, especially in the IPv4, because we don't even have enough possible IPv4 addresses. And I think Matplotlib also addresses that in one video, so I suggest you to watch that too if you are interested in how some kind of this kind of network address translation and these things work. So this is the main purpose of having IP addresses, while the MAC addresses will be mostly used to address devices on the same network. So this is actually quite funny that the MAC addresses have the 6 segments and the IP addresses only have the 4 segments, while the IP address should be globally unique and the MAC address doesn't have to be. So the MAC address can be just locally unique and there won't be any issue with that. And of course, we might think that MAC address, we need more MAC address than IP address, because there are devices that are not like available through the internet but still need a MAC address, like a Bluetooth devices have MAC addresses and things like that. So MAC addresses don't just apply to this kind of typical networking situations, but other things too. But if we are just thinking about the network, so if things are connected through repeaters, hubs, bridges or switches, those things on the same network must have unique MAC addresses, because that's where the MAC addresses are used directly to address the device. But when you are using routers, then this MAC address is not really used. So what is a repeater? Repeater is very easy. Just gets a signal from a computer and just repeats it. So this repeater doesn't appear as a unique device on the network. It will just repeat whatever message you have. So if you address from this computer, you want to send a message to here, you just use the MAC address of this computer and this repeater will just, you know, repeat the message. The same is with a hub, but the hub will get the message from this computer and just send it out to all these others, and whichever finds that the MAC address addresses them, they will then send a reply, and the reply will also be sent back to everyone. And you know, the computers can decide which is the message that is addressed to them. And of course, this system can have a lot of issues, because if two computers try to communicate at the same time, that can cause trouble. So that's why the switches were made. So the switch is a little more smart than a hub. So it will figure out what MAC address is connected to which of its ports. So if this computer sends a message and the switch knows that this MAC address belongs to this computer, then the message will only be forwarded to that computer. And when this computer responds, of course, the MAC address will be known by the switch. And so this will have much less network congestion. But of course, nowadays, so I remember when I was really young, we used switches on like local networks sometimes. But the time came when we have more advanced systems like routers. And I'm not sure how modern routers work. So it's quite possible that if you are on like this ports that are for your own local network, it will just simply act as a switch and won't bother routing. But we want to talk about just the advanced networking when the router is actually part of the network in a more involved way, instead of just repeating messages from one computer to another, because this is kind of where the difference between an IP address and a MAC address is most easily demonstrative. So here I wrote down that, for example, there is, let's take this example when we want to send a message from our local computer to this server here. So the computer has an IP address, has a MAC address, the server also has an IP address, and also have a MAC address. And so this is kind of different networks, as we can see here. Maybe this server is in a different building, whatever, it doesn't really matter. But what we know is that our computer needs to send a message to this 192.168.8.15 server, but we also realize that we are on a different network, so this case we have like a more complicated situation due to the router, so we cannot really address this computer directly, it's on a different network, but we know we have a default gateway, and the gateway is the router, so this router will have an IP address in both networks. This is how the router works, and both of these will have different MAC addresses. So, contrary to like the more simple cases with the hubs and the switches, the router itself does have its own IP and MAC addresses. So, first of all, our computer realizes that, okay, I cannot directly send a message to this IP address. I need to go through my gateway. And so, the link layer will be confused for a moment because, okay, what is this IP address? I need to have a MAC address for that, but this time, let's say we just turned this computer on, so we don't know what is the MAC address. So this will send out like a message to each computer, so they will have like a broadcast address and just send out a message that anyone who finds that this is their IP address, please respond. And so this router will send back its own MAC address and then we will get this MAC address, so the link layer will now know that this IP address belongs to this MAC address and will send the message to this MAC address. So our router receives the message and we'll see that, okay, this message is not actually coming for me, this message is going to the server, so I will have to route it there. So the router will figure out how to connect that server in this very simple example. Let's say the server is directly connected to the router, so we don't need to go through other routers, we can just directly talk to this computer, but if we don't, we can go through this same process of finding another router to send this message to. And so we can just directly send the this message to this IP address here. And for that, we also, of course, have to figure out the MAC address. So this router will send out to the other network this kind of broadcast message, which every computer gets this message, everyone needs to respond. And whoever has this IP address we are looking for will send back a message, so it will send back its own MAC address, and now we know that we need to send our message to this MAC address down there. And so this concludes my presentation, I guess. And so if you want to more information, want to have more information, there are a lot of very interesting articles and very dense articles on Wikipedia about the Internet Protocol Suite. Will tell you the overarching picture and medium access control and internet protocol and routers and the transmission control protocol and dynamic host and network address translation, all these interesting things. There is, I found actually this this website from Learn Cisco to have very good description of this process I was just recently talking about here in the video about this routing. So it will give you a more in-depth look if you are interested in it. But I think now you understand why we have both IP addresses and MAC addresses, what is the difference between them, and why it is a problem that IP addresses are running out, and why it is not a problem if MAC addresses are running out. Why don't we have to have all MAC addresses to be unique everywhere Okay, so I think this is kind of the conclusion here. So if you enjoyed this video, why don't you give me a like, thumbs up or whatever you can see there, and you can follow me on either my YouTube channel, my Odyssey channel, and follow me on Mastodon for not just updates about videos, but also other things. I interact with other free software and Linux enthusiasts on Mastodon. So if you are interested in that, why don't you follow me there too? All the links will be down there, I guess, if I don't forget to put them down there. And, well, see you next time with more tutorials, opinions, and other Linux-related things on this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you have a great day, and see you. Bye.